How was the glass made? Glassmaking is a long-established craft. It was a method that had been developed over many centuries. As technology advances, glass manufacturers have begun to produce float glass that is much stronger, more durable, and compatible with glass processing procedures such as lamination, tempering, acid etching, sandblasting, and so on. Skyscrapers with shining glass windows can be seen everywhere nowadays. Homes with large French windows are trendy. Glass partitions and shower walls are now found in almost every home. Glass is used in everything from automobiles to mobile phones. Glass is one of the most remarkable human inventions. It's hard enough to keep us safe, but it's also easily broken. Glass also has the incredible property of being a solid that allows light to pass through, a property that very few materials have. While glass is now extremely common, it was once the most valuable and sought-after material during prehistoric times. Let's learn more about how this material is made and used in our home's windows. What is glass made of? Glass, believe it or not, is made from liquid sand. Glass can be made by heating ordinary sand, which is mostly silicon dioxide, until it melts and becomes a liquid. That won't happen on your local beach. Sand melts at an extremely high temperature of 1700 degrees Celsius, or 3090 degrees Fahrenheit. When molten sand cools, it does not return to the gritty yellow stuff it came from. It undergoes a complete transformation and acquires an entirely new inner structure. But no matter how much you cool the sand, it never completely solidifies. Instead, it condenses into a frozen liquid, or what materials scientists call an amorphous solid. It's a hybrid of a solid and a liquid, with some of the solid's crystalline order and some of the liquid's molecular randomness. Glass is such a popular material in our homes because it has so many beneficial properties. Aside from being transparent, glass is inexpensive to produce, easy to shape when molten, reasonably resistant to heat when set, chemically inert, so a glass jar does not react with the contents, and it can be recycled an unlimited number of times. Who first made glass? The origin of glassmaking. The origins of glassmaking are unknown, but it is thought to have begun around 3500 BC in ancient Mesopotamia and Egypt. Beads and small objects made by the Egyptians and Mesopotamians using a core forming technique in which a core of clay or sand was coated with molten glass were the earliest known glass objects. The exact process by which glass was discovered is unclear, but it is thought to have happened by chance. It is considered that ancient people discovered glass while cooking over a fire, when a mixture of sand and other materials melted and cooled, forming natural glass. Glassmaking techniques and technology improved over time, allowing for the creation of larger and more complex glass objects such as bowls, vases, and windows. Around 50 BC, the Roman Empire developed the blowing technique, which allowed for the production of larger and more intricate glass objects. This method involves blowing air into a glass gather on the end of a blowpipe, which was then shaped and cooled. Glassmaking centers were established in the Middle Ages in Venice, Italy, and the surrounding areas, which became known for producing high-quality glass objects. Glassmaking techniques and technology evolved over the centuries, resulting in the development of new types of glass, such as lead glass and optical glass, and the widespread use of glass in a variety of industries, including construction, automotive, and optics. Pliny, the Roman historian, attributed the invention of glassmaking to Phoenician sailors. He described landing on a beach near Ptolemy, in modern-day Israel, putting a cooking pot on some blocks of natron, a naturally occurring alkali substance they were carrying as cargo, and lighting a fire to cook a meal. Surprisingly, the beach sand beneath the fire melted and ran in a liquid stream, eventually cooling and hardening into the glass. Though this is a fascinating explanation, a cooking fire cannot reach the melting temperature of the glass, and the story most likely involved Ptolemy because its beach sand was historically known to be heavily used in glassmaking. Scholars believe that the ability to make glass evolved over time through experiments with a silica sand or ground quartz pebble mixture and an alkali. Other high-temperature industries, such as ceramics and metalworking, could have influenced early glassmakers. Perhaps the development of glass began with potters firing their wares. Could the first glass have been a colorful, hard, and shiny decoration fused to the surface of a clay pot in the heat of the furnace? Nobody knows. Someone eventually created glass as a distinct substance. A glass workshop would melt and cool the glass ingredients to create ingots, or raw chunks of usable glass. Glassmakers knew how to color the ingots by incorporating metallic oxides into the mix. Popular glass colors included royal blue and turquoise blue, which were created by adding cobalt oxide and copper oxide, respectively, colorants that are still used today. Glassmakers attempted to replicate semi-precious stones, such as lapis lazuli and turquoise, which were favored by ancient cultures. The cooled ingots were shipped to completely separate workshops, some of which were quite far away, where the chunks were remelted and worked into various forms. Because less heat is required to remelt glass after it has already been formed from its raw, powdery materials, this second workshop would not have to heat its furnace to as high a temperature as the origination furnace. Glass workers were limited to the technology of the day once a workshop remelted its ingots of glass. They could cast vessels and beads and molds, fuse small pieces of glass together, and then slump the mass into, or over, a mold, grind and polish glass with stones or sand and water, or make hollow vessels by core forming. Previous to the 1st century BC, core forming was used to make 95% of all vessels. How is glass made nowadays? Glass is made using a variety of techniques, depending on the type of glass and its intended use. The float glass process is the most widely used method of producing glass today. The raw materials used in the float glass process are typically silica sand, soda ash, limestone, and dolomite. To make the glass batch, these materials are carefully measured and mixed together. The batch is then heated in a furnace to a high temperature, where it melts and becomes a liquid. The molten tin is then poured over the liquid glass, which spreads out and forms a sheet. The glass sheet is then cooled and solidified, resulting in a flat and smooth surface on both sides. Once formed, the glass can be cut and shaped to the desired size and shape. It can then be tempered, laminated, coated, or otherwise processed to achieve the desired properties for its intended use. The blown glass technique, which has been used for centuries, is another way to make glass. This method entails blowing air into a glass gather on the end of a blowpipe, which is then shaped and cooled. This technique is mostly used to create smaller glass objects like vases, bottles, and other decorative items. There are several other methods used to make glass today, in addition to the float glass process and the blown glass technique. Some examples are fused casting. This technique involves fusing crushed or ground glass together to form a solid glass block. After cooling, the block is cut into smaller pieces for further processing. Fiberglass. This method is used to produce fiberglass, a type of reinforced plastic made of glass fibers. Glass fibers are created by drawing molten glass through small holes known as bushings and stretching it into long, thin fibers. After that, the fibers are woven or pressed together to form the desired shape. Rolled glass. Similar to float glass, but the glass is cooled and solidified while passing through rollers, giving it a slightly curved or rolled shape. Stained glass. This technique is used to create decorative glass objects with a variety of colors and patterns, such as stained glass windows. To give the glass color, it is cut into the desired shapes and then painted or coated with metallic oxides. The pieces are then put together to form the finished product. Glass production is a complex process that requires precise control of raw materials, temperature, and timing in order to achieve the desired properties and quality of glass. Also, the process used will be determined by the type of glass being made, and the end use of the glass is an important factor in the process selection.